The bell metal industry of Assam occupies an imperative position in the tradition, culture, and economy of Assamese society. It is required for various domestic and religious uses and is the second largest handicraft of Assam after bamboo craft. Sathebari of Assam is considered to be the home of bell metal industry. It has occupied a distinct place in Assam due to its uniqueness of being associated with the production of bell metal items, which is an important craftsmanship of every household of Sathebari. The history of origin of bell metal industry dates back to the 7th century AD when Kumar Bhaskar Barman, the then king of Barman dynasty, gifted bell metal drinking vessels to Harshavardhan, the king of Kannauj, in order to develop mutual friendship with him. Moreover, a pair of taal was gifted to Huensang, an eminent Chinese scholar, during his visit to India, and Kamrup. The Ahom rulers and aristocrats found great pleasure by eating food in bell metal dishes and bowls. The Ahom kings also engaged the craftsmen to produce bell metal guns and cannonballs, the remains of which are still preserved in the State Museum of Assam at Guwahati. The Ahom king Sargadyo Sevasingha patronized the creative pursuits of the craftsmen to acquire an in-depth knowledge about the bell metal industry from close quarters and to gather a practical experience of the overall process of producing bell metal items. A trip to Sathebari was organized by the Center for Advanced Research in Intellectual Property, shortly known as CARIP, under the National Law University and Judicial Academy, Assam, on 1st of April 2019. The trip was planned with a view to reintroduce the significance of traditional knowledge and culture of bell metal industry of Assam. Sathebari is a town located at a distance of around 90 kilometers to the west of Guwahati in Barpeta district of Assam. The name of the places are still known by its old village names, and the place where we visited is called Jugorbori Supa. More than 40% of the population of this area is engaged in the traditional activity of making of bell metal utensils. After reaching Sathebari at around 11 a.m., we were received by a young localite named Mantu Kalita, who guided us to some of the bell metal utensils producing units. As we passed by the locality, the tinkling sound of pounding the metal was audible from each household. Kalita took us to one unit where we saw the artisans were busy making bell metal dishes. We got to know that usually in each of the units there are around 7 to 8 artisans working. Of these artisans, the main craftsman is known as the Kahar. These artisans intimated us that there has been a very little transition in the method of preparing bell metal items, and that they mostly resort to age-old tools and equipments for preparing the items. Our curiosity to know more about bell metal intended us to meet a Kahar, and accordingly we headed to another production unit where we got the opportunity to meet Manoranjan Deka, who is a Kahar.
আমার কেসা সামগ্রী লাগে কাসা এই কাসা তো আমার
Deka is pursuing this profession since last 25 to 30 years and has inherited the skill of making of bell metal items from his forefathers, who too were Kahars. He told us that the main raw materials required are charcoal and old scrap bell metal utensils hired from outside Assam, like Rajasthan, Gujarat, Moradabad, and sometimes even outside India, like Afghanistan, Pakistan, etc. He gave us a demo on how a bell metal dish is prepared. Our discussions with Deka and his helper artisans brought into light some of the very crucial problems that the bell metal industry of Sathebari in general and the artisans in particular are facing, of which the most severe one is that the industry is facing tough competition from cheaper quality substitute products made of plastic, aluminum, etc., which has taken over the market of bell metal products. As witnessed, this bell metal making process requires huge physical strength and efforts, and as a result, the artisans often suffer from severe health hazards like loss of vision, heart diseases, and neurological problems, reducing their longevity. Another major problem is inadequate supply of charcoal. Being financially weak, the artisans cannot depend on private sources, and therefore they rely on domestic production of coal generated by burning wood obtained from cutting of trees at a local level. In addition, the artisans are not getting proper or adequate monetary return. Besides, the artisans are not getting adequate support and incentives from the government. They do not have access to ration cards and health benefit cards. The government gives pensions to the artisans above 60 years of age, but in many cases, the artisans do not survive till this age due to serious health problems associated with this industry. After Deka, we continued our conversations with Mantu Kalita, who beautifully elucidated the process of making of bell metal utensils.
প্রথমতে সব কা এটা শঙ্কর ধাতু ইংরেজি অ্যালয় বলি হয় ইয়াতে তাম আৰু টিন থাকে তাম থাকে 80% টিন থাকে টিঙক আমি রাং বলি কও ঘৰুৱা রাং বলি কয় এখেতসকলে শিল্পীবিলাকে রাং বলি কব কিন্তু আমি ঘৰুৱা বিজ্ঞানৰ ভাষাত
তামকো আপোনালোকে কিবা বেলেগ বলি কয় নেকি
তাম কপাৰ তাম তাম বুলি কয় তাম বুলি এইটো এটা শংকৰ ধাতু হয় শংকৰ ধাতুটো দুইটা গলাই পেলাই টেম্পাৰেচাৰ দি আমি এলয়টো বনাব পাৰিম আৰু পৰ্থেবাৰীৰ কাঁহ শিল্পৰ কাৰণে এই এলয়টোৱে হৈছে একমাত্ৰ কেঁচা সামগ্ৰী আৰু এই কেঁচা সামগ্ৰীটোক লৈ যাক যেনেকুৱা উৎপাদক লাগে প্ৰডাক্টছ লাগে প্ৰডাক্টছবোৰ হ'ল কাঁহী বাতি তাল কিছুমান ফুটিয়া তাল আছে এইবিলাক ভূটানত চেপাৰেটলি বেলেগকৈ গুচি যায় বানবাতি বানকাঁহী সৰু সৰু আজিকালি থাল হৈছে জেলবাতি পুষ্পৰাম কুহাৰে বনাইছিলে জেলতে ব্ৰিটিছে তাইৰ কাৰণে তেখেতক এইটো মাফো দিছিলে ম্যাদ মানে উকালাই দিছিলে এই প্ৰডাক্টছবোৰ বিভিন্ন আছে কাঁহী বাতি মোটামুটি ষোল্ল বিশ বিধ বহুত প্ৰডাক্টছ আছে কিছুমান প্ৰডাক্টছ আমি এতিয়া নবনাওঁ হ'লোঁ কিছুমান নচনাল হ'ল দিনত কাঁহী বাতি পাতা এইবিলাক অত্যাধিক হাৰত আমাৰ ইয়াতে পুৰা দিনত চলি আছে
দ্য স্ক্ৰেপ মেটেল আইটেমছ আৰ পাৰ্চেছড বাই দ্য ভিলেজ ক্ৰাফ্টছমেন ফ্ৰম দ্য আসাম কোঅপাৰেটিভ বেল মেটেল ইউটেনচিলছ মেনুফেকচাৰিং চোচাইটি অৰ লোকেলি নোন এজ Assam Samabai Kahar Sangha Limited, or from the local shops of the town, or sometimes even from some private entrepreneurs from Guwahati. After procuring the raw materials, the craftsman first of all hits the old bell metal items and then breaks into small pieces with the help of a hammer. The pieces has to be so finely broken that it enables the artisans to put the tiny metal pieces in the narrow vessels locally called muhi, which are then put inside a narrow fire vent also known as kah golua apor in the local language. The fire is burned with the help of charcoal and is occasionally pumped air with a machine into the burning charcoal to ignite the flames. The burning charcoal melts the small pieces of metals into liquefied form, giving a beautiful red yellowish hue. After the metal takes complete molten form, the muhi or the narrow vessels are taken out of the apor or the narrow fire vent. These are then poured over the surface of the mold, that is aak. The molten metal solidifies very quickly, forming small round shape just like small pancakes. The next stage is to flatten the small pancake shaped metals into wider plates by beating with hammer. It is an old traditional practice which requires massive force and strength and thus consumes more labor hour. Therefore, it is a time-consuming step. But thanks to the invention of the rolling machine, which has made the work of the artisans easier by doing the same work in no time. In this context, it is worthwhile to mention that the samabai gets rupees 3 to 4 kg of metal for doing the work of flattening of small round shaped metals. The wide and flattened shaped metal obtained from the rolling machines are brought to the production units, and then the remaining task of giving shape and polishing is done. For this, a sharp-edged tool, locally called tikha, is used to give a shiny appearance, and then the engraving designs are sold in the market against appropriate remuneration. The local terms for the utensils are banbati, bankahi, bota, horai, hortal, hutiatal, etc. The production units where bell metal items are produced are locally known as Kahor Gorhal. To know about the marketing facilities, we then move to the hub of bell metal items, that is the Assam Cooperative Bell Metal Utensils Manufacturing Society Limited, and interacted with the members of the society. The society was established in 1933. The society gives a platform to the bell metal artisans to sell their finished products either within or outside the town. At that time, the conditions of the local artisans were very pathetic.
তেওঁলোকে নিজ খুশি মতে তাৰমানে মজুৰিটো দিয়ে, মজুৰি দিয়ে, আনকি তেওঁলোকৰ দোকানৰ গাদীত যাই পদাৰ্পণ কৰাৰ কাৰণেও কিবা এটা কমিছন কাটি লয়, এনেকুৱা ধৰণৰ এটা শোষণ চলি আছিল। সেয়ে 1933ৰ আগত লেট কহিৰাম দাস তেওঁ বিয়ে অনাৰ ফাৰ্ষ্ট অসমত, তেখেতে এটা অনুভৱ কৰিলে আৰু এডুকেটেড পাৰ্চন আছিল আমাৰ এই অঞ্চলটো। আৰু তেতিয়া তেখেতে গোটেই কোহাৰখিনিক একত্ৰিত কৰি 1933 চনৰ 5 নৱেম্বৰ দিনাখন এই অনুষ্ঠানটো জন্ম দিছিল।
দ্য বেল মেটেল চিম্বল অৰ মিউজিকেল ইনষ্ট্ৰুমেণ্ট অফ সাথেবাৰী ইজ ভেৰি পপুলাৰ এমাংছ দ্য বুদ্ধিষ্ট কাণ্ট্ৰিজ লাইক চাইনা, জাপান, ভূটান, নেপাল, এটচেট্ৰা। দে ট্ৰাই টু ইমিটেট দ্য আৰ্ট অফ মেকিং বেল মেটেল চিম্বলছ ইউজিং advanced machineries. However, they invariably failed in their attempt because the machine-made cymbals were unable to produce the exact sound and vibration required for their purpose. The members of the society also emphasize the fact that the sustainability of Assamese tradition and culture depends to a large extent on the development of the bell metal craft. Currently, the cooperative society is working hard to achieve geographical indication status with respect to the origin of bell metal from Sarthebari. Besides, the society is also thankful to the former governor of Assam, late J.B. Patnaik, under whose aegis the society was sanctioned an amount of Rs. 5 crores of interest-free loan in 2012, of which they have already received 2 crores in 2013 and the remaining amount is still under process to be released. Thus, we had a very fruitful conversation with the members of the society, which was followed by some light refreshment being arranged by them. Our team was very delighted to see that the members have served us tea and snacks in beautiful traditional bell metal utensils. They also informed us that having food in bell metal utensils bear great medicinal benefit. Our team then felicitated all the members of the society with Phulam Gamusa, and they too gifted us one beautiful bell metal botta or a mounted tray. In this way, our day at Sarthebari ended with each one of us acquiring thorough knowledge about the bell metal industry. Our trip will be a huge success only if our efforts can result in concrete measures which will lead to the revival of the bell metal industry so that it can flourish again with prestige and glory as in the era of Ahom Kingdom.